थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू सर। The main thing is when you're when cataract surgeons are operating for cataract surgery in the preoperative examination, they are feeling that the amount of cataract is not corresponding to the checked vision, best corrected visual acuity. Then obviously, and the fundus is looking more or less normal, you're not able to visualize anything significant pathological in the pathology in the macula. And obviously, slit lamp examination only is not enough. You need obviously need to do a optical coherence tomography also. So a lot of most of the cataract surgeons have included optical coherence tomography as a routine part of their cataract workup, even in the absence of any significant doubt in the vision or in the macular changes. So probably from in the days to come, this will be the routine as part of a routine cataract workup. So what is vitreo macular attraction is as the aging process or because of other pathological conditions like myopia or inflammation and other things. When the vitreous cortex shrinks, it is separate from the retina. An incomplete separation with attachments at the posterior pole can lead to tractional forces generating anatomical damage to the posterior pole, that's the macula. The International Vitreomacular Traction Study Group, they have defined vitreomacular adhesion as a scenario where there is incomplete separation within the 3 millimeters of the fovea. It's an arbitrary measurement, but it's not causing any tractional effects on the surface of the retina. Then it's called as vitreomacular adhesion. It can be either focal when it is less than 1 disc area, and when it is more than 1 disc area, it is called broad-based vitreomacular adhesion. There is no tractional effect, which is totally normal in this scenario. But when you have a tractional component, then it can lead to early surface changes in the surface layers of the fovea. It can lead to in the intraretinal pseudocyst. It can lead to outer or inner lamellar hole or a full thickness macular hole. So all these things can happen. So when you have a coexisting diseases, both of the macula as well as a cataract, then you have confusion on which to address first or whether to address both entities as the same sitting. When you have a very significant cataract, like in the left picture we see, where you're not able to exactly assess the impact of the macular pathology on vision. You're able to pick up a mild changes in the OCT, dull images, but you're not able to exactly assess, then you can always first do cataract surgery. But when you have a little bit less intense cataract, like a grade 1 nucleus sclerosis or grade 2 nucleus sclerosis, which you should be able to get corrected by a refractive correction, and you're having improper recovery of best vision still is subnormal, then you have a confusion. Like in these cases, if you do the cataract first, the patient is usually very much disappointed with the postoperative visual recovery. So first, if you consider vitreomacular attraction, what are the treatment options? When there is no significant changes in the visual acuity or there's no history of symptoms of distortion, then it's obviously observation. There's no drop in the vision and there is no history of distortion, then you can always observe. But any of these symptoms is present, then the option is usually vitrectomy. But other options you can consider, right now Jetria is not available in India, oculoplasmin injection. And people have also tried pneumatic retina vitreolysis, where they inject a small bubble of air in the vitreous to disturb the vitreous and separate the incomplete separated vitreous in the posterior pole. But again, it has got its own complications there. Sometimes it can lead to a full thickness macular hole or it can lead to peripheral retinal tears. It's not a very safe or very much choice of treatment. So usually the best choice, most predictable outcome is with the vitrectomy surgery. I'm just showing some videos of what we do with the cases referred to us. This is the case of vitreomacular traction of the foveal cyst. Here we are just breaking the hyoid with a sharp bent needle and then trying to make these vitreous into a surrounding island at the fovea. So here we didn't want to break the foveal cyst, and then we just trimmed off into a separate island and allowing the retina to settle after that. So you can see that the OCT is now, the traction is relieved, and now the retina is settling. After 2-3 months, it will come down to more or less normal configuration. This is again a dioptic retinopathy with the vitreomacular cyst, you can see here. So in this case, when I was trying to make it an island and try to remove the vitreous, it was not coming off, and I think I produced a small iatrogenic tear. So then we had to progress to go ahead and do an internal membrane peeling to address the iatrogenic macular hole here. So in this case, you can see that the vitreous, the ERM, everything is into a single complex. And as you can see the thickened vitreous here, and you do a vitrectomy and induce the elevation of the epiretinal component, and then the needle itself you can just strip it off, and there's no injury to the MAC loss. This is what we do once the case is referred. You can see the image showing the recovery of the interaction postoperatively. More thing is epithelial membrane and the lamellar hole epithelial proliferation. This is the pre-operative picture. You can see the epithelial proliferation here, and this is the post-operative picture showing the ILM peeling and the stuffed up LHEP proliferative material into the lamellar hole. So this is the algorithm in the Western countries where they have occiplastin, but in India, we have only surgery. We don't have a pneumatic vitrolysis, also not very much popular here. So if we have a cataract which is mild and we feel that this should come to 6-6 with a refractive correction, then cataract is very mild, you can go for directly vitrectomy only. But you have a significant amount of cataract and there's macular pathology, you feel that is a responsibility to vision drop, you can always go with a phaco with combined vitrectomy in a single sitting. But if you have a very dense cataract where you're not able to assess what is causing the vision loss, you do the phaco first and then recheck the vision and then go ahead with your vitrectomy.